This is Chicago. For decades, the skyline here has been defined by giants. The John Hancock Center, standing 457 meters tall, was a structure that redefined the limits of the possible. But imagine, just for a moment, taking that sheer scale and doubling it. Imagine a structure that doesn't just scrape the sky, but pierces the troposphere, rising a full kilometer into the air. This isn't a vanity project. It isn't a hotel for the ultra-wealthy. This is a machine, a colossal vertical battery capable of storing 1.7 gigawatt hours of clean, renewable energy. That is enough power to run a medium-sized city or stabilize the grid for millions of people every single day. We are looking at a proposal that marries the ambition of the Burj Khalifa with the utility of a power plant. This is the Gravity Energy Tower, and if the engineers behind it are right, it could be the silent, massive architect of our green future. Please take a moment to subscribe and like the video. It really helps the channel. To understand why anyone would propose building a concrete structure taller than the Burj Khalifa, you have to understand the crisis unfolding on the ground. Right now, the global power grid is facing an unprecedented stress test. Electricity demand is not simply rising, it is skyrocketing, driven by the very technologies that define our modern world. The explosive expansion of AI infrastructure, the global switch to electric vehicles, and an industrial sector hungry for electrification. The numbers are terrifying. A single AI hyperscale data center can now consume the equivalent energy of 100,000 homes. As these facilities multiply, the strain on our aging grids is becoming critical. Many experts are now sounding the alarm. Without a major structural innovation, the goal of running the world on 100% renewable energy by 2030 will be completely and utterly unreachable. We are building a digital world that our physical grids simply cannot support. Here lies the fundamental conflict of the 21st century. Solar and wind energy are exceptional at generating cheap power, but they are disastrously bad at reliability. When the sun sets or the wind drops, the power stops. This intermittency is the Achilles heel of the renewable revolution. To break our addiction to fossil fuels, we need load shifting, taking excess power generated at noon and deploying it hours later when demand peaks. Currently, we rely on lithium-ion batteries. But while lithium is fantastic for your car, it is difficult to scale for a national grid. It degrades over time, carries significant fire risks, and relies on complex, ethically fraught supply chains. We need something simpler, something that lasts. The best solution might just be the oldest trick in the engineering book, potential energy. The concept driving this mega project is pure, elegant physics. It is based on the exact same principles used for decades in pumped hydro storage, which still accounts for over 90% of all grid-scale energy storage worldwide. The mechanism is brutally simple. You use excess electricity to pump water up a hill into a reservoir. When you need power, you release the water down through turbines. It is a giant water-based battery. But there is a catch. Pumped hydro requires specific geography, two massive reservoirs and a mountain. You cannot build a pumped hydro plant in downtown New York. This geographical limitation has forced engineers to look for a way to liberate gravity storage from the mountains. The solution? If nature won't give you a mountain, you build one. The modern gravity tower relocates that proven hydro principle into vertical man-made superstructures. Companies like Energy Vault are pioneering EVU concepts, towers that could reach up to 1,000 meters. This design is a paradigm shift. It minimizes environmental disruption and eliminates the dependency on natural topography. Suddenly, gravity storage can be deployed in the remote deserts of Saudi Arabia next to sprawling solar fields, or integrated into the dense urban centers of Shanghai or London. To hold up gigawatt hours of sheer mass, the structure itself has to be an engineering marvel. The design often favors a cylindrical soda can shape. In the world of super tall skyscrapers, wind is the enemy. A cylinder confuses the wind, allowing it to flow around the structure, reducing stress on the core. This allows the tower to act as a rigid spine, lifting and lowering massive weights or water volumes internally without tearing itself apart. The question remains, why go so high? Why push for the kilometer mark? The answer lies in the formula for potential energy. Mass times gravity times height. Gravity is constant. Mass is expensive to move. Height, however, is the multiplier that delivers the biggest economic gains. Doubling the height of the tower roughly doubles your storage capacity without requiring a single extra square meter of land. It is an exponential return on investment. At 1 kilometer, the tower maximizes the drop, allowing the weights to generate power for longer durations. This scale is what allows a single structure to achieve that staggering 1.7 gigawatt hours capacity. To put that in context, the largest battery storage facility in the world usually caps out at a few hundred megawatt hours. This tower would dwarf them. Building a structure that rivals the Jeddah Tower is an epic logistical challenge. But the methods proposed are tried and tested. Slipform construction. This is the same technique used to build the cores of the world's tallest skyscrapers. Slipforming is essentially a factory in the sky. A continuous ring of formwork moves upward, jacked by hydraulic systems, while concrete is poured continuously into the top. It rises at a rate of about 25 centimeters per hour, roughly 6 meters every single day. At this speed, the main shaft of a standard tower could be finished in months. The real challenge lies in the active systems. This isn't just a static concrete tube, it's a machine. The elevators or linear motor systems that lift the weights must operate with perfect precision, handling loads that would snap a standard cable. This is where the gravity tower truly beats its chemical counterparts. A lithium-ion battery farm will need its cells replaced every 10 to 15 years. Its capacity will fade. A gravity tower does not fade. Gravity does not degrade. The structural shell, concrete and steel, is designed to last for 50 to 100 years. Furthermore, gravity storage has zero self-discharge. You can lift a weight to the top of the tower and leave it there for months. When you release it, you get the exact same energy back. While the upfront cost is astronomical, likely exceeding $1 billion for a kilometer-high version, the mathematics change when you look at the long term. When amortized over a half century of operation, the cost becomes highly competitive. It is a generational asset. So, where will the first of these giants rise? The ideal location combines cheap land, massive renewable generation, and high industrial demand. We are looking at the sun-soaked plains of Texas and Arizona, the industrial heartlands of China, and the mega projects of the Middle East. These are regions where the pain of energy instability is greatest, and the pockets are deep enough to fund the prototype. Currently, there are no finalized contracts to break ground on a 1 kilometer version tomorrow. The regulatory hurdles and funding requirements are immense. It is unlikely we will see a topped-out kilometer tower before 2030. But the technology is moving from the lab to the real world. These towers represent a new era of functional architecture. They prove that we can take the brute force of nature, gravity, and tame it to solve the most complex problem of the modern age. The race to build the ultimate battery is on, and the winner might just touch the clouds.